Leg two of the Volvo Ocean Race from Lisbon to Cape Town had been tough. For the new crew, this was their longest time at sea by far. For navigators, the 19-day leg had been intense and stressful.
We're just off the Brazilian coast, probably 400 miles.
There's been a little bit of a high-pressure ridge, and it's forcing us a little bit further to the west.
A bit of snakes and ladders, a bit of back and forth, a bit of bungee cord, you know.
Conditions are constantly changing, especially here in these trade winds where it can easily go from 10 to 20 knots of wind.
The race south to the equator from Lisbon had been close, the fleet barely out of sight of each other. Once in the southern hemisphere, a large area of light winds ahead blocked their path, forcing the fleet to stay west.
So sort of can't shake them off at the moment, they keep coming at us, you know. But that's all right. Good, good two-boat testing.
Every time they've come within distance, we've let them get away, so we're determined to keep them this time.
Timing the turn to the east would be critical.
Fought so hard, being off the pace, to stay in the game, and don't want to just make a rash decision and throw it away, so it's a difficult time.
How do you think, really think we should drive?
Okay, let's drive.
Yeah. Okay, we're going to drive, how was it?
Decision made, jibing.
When they did, the reach across the South Atlantic provided a soaking, high-speed taste of the infamous Southern Ocean. The tactical challenge off the South American coast had seen Mapfre come out on top as they led into Cape Town.
Super happy. This is, you know, for us, the first leg was very good already, being second in Lisbon, but of course it's winning here and winning the first big, you know, long leg is very happy, very proud of.
Behind them, Dong Feng heaved a sigh of relief, having pulled themselves back from fourth after tripping up at the turn to take second.
It's a nice second place after what happened. Made a big mistake. We did a complicated thing to take the lead and we just saw a stupid thing.
Next across the line was Vestas 11th Hour Racing taking third. From here, the focus turned to leg four, 6,500 miles from Cape Town to Melbourne, Australia, across the wastes of the Southern Ocean.
I never sailed in the Southern Ocean, will be the first time, so I'm quite anxious and nervous. Never experienced so much cold that I think I will experience now. So I hope that I'm ready, all my kit is ready, and I will trust on that.
All the people told me that the South Ocean is hard, but it's amazing too. I know that sometimes it's dangerous because of the strong condition, but I think that I'm in an experienced team, so I'm safety with them, so I'm not worried about this. But yes, I have a little tip that I'll tell you in Australia, not now. It's a secret.
As they contemplated what lay ahead, some took time to visit the first key landmark of the leg, the Cape of Good Hope.
Certainly leaving the loved ones and mum and talking to them the last time before you head off to a leg like this, it's, you do have second thoughts about what you're going through, what you're putting them through, at the same time as, yeah, you're doing the thing you love, and everyone's always saying, make sure you wear your harness, be safe, wear your life jacket, and those are the things that are going through your head when you're going through these manoeuvres and you're up on the foredeck with your harness on, your life jacket on, you make sure you clip on because you literally hear that coming through your head, but someone in the back of your mind saying, be safe, because yeah, it does get pretty ropey up there.
Bom, eu acho que essa perna vai ser muito mais dura do que a outra perna que a gente fez, e vai ser um desafio mental, sanidade física e mental de conviver a bordo com condições tão extremas. E para mim vai ser uma das pernas mais icônicas do oceano do sul, onde, no mar austral, onde grandes velejadores são forjados.
Be told by all the veterans, all the legends, just this is going to be the hardest leg that I'll ever do. Going straight into this leg, knowing that it's going to be cold, it's going to be wet, it's going to be a lot of hard work and not much sleep. The Southern Ocean's kind of got this ominous feel about it, that you don't really know what it's going to be like until you're there.
As the start loomed, The tension built as the weather predictions filtered through.
Leg three is shaping up right now to be a true, proper Southern Ocean leg. The Cape Town exit is not too dissimilar to what we had last time that we were here. So there's no easing into leg three. It's full on, straight from the beginning. These guys will be 30 to 40 knots at times. Everything that you hear about the Southern Ocean, for big breeze, big waves, cold air, cold water, it's all gonna be there, and it's all gonna be straight in their face right from the beginning.
And it was. The opening conditions were just as brutal as the forecast suggested, as the fleet punched its way upwind. But there was far more to come. A weather bomb was developing astern as vicious winds of 40 to 60 knots driving 10 to 15 meter seas approached from behind. Join us next month to find out how the fleet fared.